What's a next generation game, really? We came to E3 2013 to find out. Here we've got the PlayStation 4, the Xbox One, PCs galore. But what are these games all about?
Of course, better graphics play a role. Xbox and PlayStation developers are competing to build the most photorealistic virtual cars we've ever seen, and most every PS4 and Xbox One game looks way better than games built for the previous generation of consoles. Characters and environments are more richly detailed, and where many PS3 and Xbox 360 games didn't even technically run at 720p, full 1080p HD is practically a given now. And what could be more glorious than exploring a giant open world at 1080p? Assassin's Creed Black Flag, Dead Rising 3, even Metal Gear Solid 5 are promising huge environments to explore, whether you're sailing a pirate ship around the Caribbean, hiding from hordes of zombies in a giant city, or navigating Afghanistan by horse. Those vast worlds are also more interactive and immersive than ever before. Some promise to let you carve a path through the world, dynamically changing the environment, while others simply put armies of characters on screen at the same time. Those characters might not just be cannon fodder, either. They could each have their own backstory, and make you think twice about shooting them in the back of the head. Even as open-world titles do away with the idea of breaking games into levels, the graphical power and speed of next-gen machines are helping to bridge the gap between cutscenes and gameplay. While there's still work to be done, it may no longer feel like you're watching one game and playing a different, less graphically impressive one. While we're talking about seamless experiences, how about throwing multiplayer into the mix? Several studios are working on titles that allow friends, more bitter rivals, to seamlessly join your ostensibly single-player game, while others are trying to build multiplayer games that feel like they have a real narrative. When you turn off your next-generation console or PC, the game won't necessarily end, at least not if you've got a companion app for your smartphone or tablet. You'll create worlds, command armies, and remotely help your friends, or use the device as a virtual reality GPS so you don't get lost in a virtual world. We're just beginning to see what next-gen games are capable of here at E3 2013, looking at the work of developers who began building these games with only a hunch about the possibilities on tap, and even then, we're only seeing the initial versions of these games they created. There's still plenty left to explore.